Hi everyone, Miss Melinda here, your spiritual worker from Miss Melinda's Metaphysical Services.com, here to bring you my six-part series on how to begin working with your ancestors. This is the number one most asked question in my live spirit chats, as well as in one-on-one communication with folks. So I'm creating this series to assist you with beginning your journey of creating your relationship with your ancestors and working with your ancestors. In this video series, I'm coming from a universalist perspective, meaning that these are the foundational techniques and this is the foundational information that will allow you to begin this practice regardless of what your spiritual beliefs or your religious beliefs may be. This is a practice that is meant to be combined with whatever tradition you personally follow, and whatever spiritual or religious beliefs that you already have personally. So if you have a tradition that you're following, you're going to want to take that into consideration and combine that in conjunction with the information here as well. And we're going to begin with the physical logistics of what you need and how to begin. So this means setting up your ancestor altar. And your ancestor altar doesn't have to be complicated. It doesn't have to be particularly fancy. So you can clear a space, a clean space on the floor to dedicate to your ancestors. You can convert an end table. You can convert a space on your kitchen counter. The important thing is that this is a dedicated space, so a space that you are dedicating through your intention and through your actions. One way to dedicate the space with your actions is to spiritually cleanse it. You can do something very simple, wipe down the area with some Florida water, create a magical water of your own creation, such as a homemade Florida water, perhaps some citrus water or some essential oils, whatever you prefer working with and whatever you're already familiar with using as a spiritual cleanse will be appropriate. The important part is that you're putting in the work, you're putting in the dedication, and you're putting in the intention to cleanse and clear this space and dedicate it to the sacred relationship between you and your ancestors. If you choose to use fabric or items on your altar, you're going to want to start with using only white. White is a color of purity. White is a color of protection. This is going to symbolize that you want this to be a clean connection. What I mean when I say clean is that this is a strong and clear connection, that this is about your spiritual purity, that you're coming from a place of spiritual purity within yourself, that you're coming with pure intentions, the pure intention to create and strengthen this relationship, the pure intention to honor and revere your ancestors without ulterior motives for personal power or ego-driven motivations. White symbolizes all of this, as well as symbolizing protection. And we're going to be discussing protection, prevention, and so forth in video number two coming up next. So in many traditions, an altar will face the direction east. And this is something that is very common throughout cultures, throughout history, and throughout many different practices and traditions. So if you don't have a tradition of your own and you're really unsure about where to put your altar, start by facing it in the direction east. And what it means by facing the direction east is that when you are standing or sitting in front of it, you are facing the direction east. And what you will put on your altar is very simple in the beginning. You don't need a lot. What I recommend is a clean surface, as we've spoken about. If you want to use a cloth, you can even use a handkerchief. So a white cloth or handkerchief, if you so choose. If you don't, that's okay. And then a clear glass filled with pure spring water, blessed water, or water that is as pure as you can get your hands on. So if you can't get spring water or something of that sort, then you can always learn to charge and bless your own water. And if you aren't sure what I'm talking about, then simply put your hands over the water, say a prayer over that water, and bless the water from your heart in your own words. However, if you do know a bit about spiritual channeling or charging an item with energy, then be sure to charge that water with some spiritual energy or with your own energy, depending on how you work, to bless that water and give it some added intention and some added energy. You can also put something very simple on your altar, such as incense, but it's not necessary. One white candle and one clear glass of blessed or spring water is all that you really need. And by a white candle, I mean one stick candle, one utility candle, one chime candle, one taper candle, one small white candle. This is your offering to your ancestors. The clear water and the white candle are the only two offerings that you need to begin with. The significance of the candle is the illumination that comes from the fire. And what we're symbolizing there and what we are calling upon there is the energy to illuminate the path of our ancestors. Through offering them light, we are physically and symbolically offering them illumination, which equates to spiritual evolution. So the whole intention behind our connection with our ancestors is spiritual evolution. Right? So we're helping them with their spiritual evolution and they're helping us with our spiritual evolution. This is a reciprocal relationship. The intention, symbolism, and action behind the water is to offer clarity. So the clarity in our connection with them, the clarity in our relationship and communication with them, the clarity in the messages and signs that we receive from them, and the clarity in our connection to them, meaning that we do not become clouded, that we do not become confused, and meaning that we do not become ego-driven, that we do not get out of line from our true intentions, which is to create an uplifting relationship based on respect, honor, dedication, and spiritual evolution. These are the only basic offerings that you need in the beginning. And if you determine that you would like to increase these offerings, for beginning offerings, I recommend nothing more than the clear water, the white candle, perhaps some incense or some black coffee, maybe some flowers. These, if you want to get fancier with your offerings, the only things I recommend are the incense, the coffee, and the flowers. The candle and the water are plenty for the beginning. So stay tuned. We're going to delve a little bit deeper in video number 2, where we're going to be talking about protection and prevention. Thanks so much, everyone. Be blessed.